Captain Andy, I'm sorry we couldn't stay for Magnolia's concerts, but our private plane is waiting.
We hated to leave your little entertainment. It was very amusing. Oh, yes.
Well, now, I'm sure glad you liked the show.
It's so quaint.
But you see, things are so different in Hollywood.
Yes, being the parents of little Frankie Schultz, the wonder boy of the silver screen, we do have our social position to maintain.
Wasn't that a stroke of luck, you two adopting that boy? And him turning out to be the screen knockout.
Well, Captain Andy, if you're ever in beautiful California, do look us up at our Palatian villa.
I'm sure glad to see you doing so well in Flickers.
Well, yes, it's an exacting art, but between you and I, the social life in Hollywood is pretty swift.
Oh, Frank, don't be so illegitimate.
Aren't you Mrs. Hawk's granddaughter, Kim Ravenaugh, the musical comedy star?
Yes, I'm Kim Ravenaugh.
I think you're marvelous. Are you ever going to play the showboat?
Getting $1,000 a week on Broadway, why would you want to play a showboat?
Oh, I'd love to see you act. I know I'll never make it to New York.
Why don't you give an impersonation of your ma singing, "Why Do I Love You"? Now, just a sample.
All right. Why do I love you? Why do you love me? Why should there be two happy as we? Can you see the why or wherefore I should be the one you care for?
That's how my mother, Magnolia Ravenaugh, sings it. But here's how we sing it today. You're a lucky boy, I am lucky too. All our dreams of joy seem to come true. Maybe that's because you love me. Maybe that's why I love you. Woo!
Just one for Captain Andy, just one for...
it's been a long time.
It has. Andy, does Nola know about this?
She don't know a thing. I sent her a telegram inviting her to the opening of the brand new Cotton Blossom, and she and Kim took a train, arrived here this morning. They're both in the showboat.
Andy, when I wrote to you, it was because... Well, because I guess you're the only real friend I ever had. And because I longed so to see Nola again. But now, I don't know. Maybe it's better if I just drop back out of sight again. She's happy now. Her life's complete.
I don't know about that, Gay. Don't you ever want to see Kim?
Does she look anything like Nola?
Spitting image of her. Oh, well, she's got a lot of your ways, too. Kind of dignified. More refined than most of the gals you see around today. Oh, well, she talks like him. She dresses like him. But, well, she don't overdo it. I mean, when she sits in a chair, she realizes the human knee is a joint and not an entertainment.
Oh, I'd give a good deal to see her again. I just don't dare. I don't think that I'd better.
Trouble with you is you keep blaming yourself for things. The fact is, you was just unlucky. Now, the lucky people, they always get to do whatever they want to do. Like me, I always wanted to run a showboat, and I made a success of it. Nola was meant to be on Broadway, and she got there. And you... Well, you was meant to be a gentleman. Biggest mistake you ever made was trying to earn a living. Nobody ever expected it of you. You was on the right track when you became a leading man on the river. You could have gotten to be a big Broadway star. You wouldn't have had to work at all.
Andy!
Oh, that's Pothy. I better go in and see what the hell she wants. She's always calling me for
Andy,
something.
Would you explain something to me?
Huh? What?
Well, now, you've been married for all these years, and still, every time she calls, you jump. Now, what is it? What has she got?
Pothy? Oh, Pothy has got... Pothy has got... She's got... a mean disposition. There's a brand new water barrel up front. It's a mite like the old one.
What